permissible to you when there's no women around? That's what my daddy said.
Are you saying this is not
that's
true?
Why Jesus called your dog.
Then stop trying to debate.
No. Get me the hadith from Sahih Bukhari.
So is this true? I'm about to read.
Read hot.
The Bible says that.
It says to Moses, kill a woman and leave the children. Little girls. Why are you left the little girls for?
You're committing sin.
Look.
See what lie you said. Did you say that?
Christian man believes marriage only sex. Is marriage only sex? And my question, is marriage only sex?
You're embarrassing yourself.
Because Christianity is marriage only sex.
Wallah, it's waste of time. Is marriage only sex? Is marriage only sex? Is marriage only sex? A woman is a sex toy. To you, Christian woman. No, woman, we respect her. We love her. We take care of her. To the Christians, she's a sex toy. To the Christian woman, she's a sex toy. Not every Christian person, yeah? This one specific. You don't have to be just. Because I'm Christian and I don't say that.
So the,
she loves to be sex toy.
No, you
can you stay away from me, please?
With your hair.
Okay, so
very nice.
Allah, save us. Anyway, because you God, breastfed. You God with such a woman breast. You God with such a woman breast.
Go. It's not
you said Prophet Muhammad, kadab, liar, evil. You evil innocent. You just said Prophet Muhammad, put the fire, liar. Look at you with the evil face.
Young God is a pedophile.
Where did I say Muhammad is a pedophile?
Yes.
Why?
Get in my dash of nine.
Is there a problem with it?
Is there a problem with it?
Because it's filthy, disgusting. Yeah, anyway,
I said yes. Let's go back.
Can I speak to him? Muhammad is
in the Bible, God who's touching woman's breast is that disgusting enough?
Keep the little ones for us.
Is it that disgusting?
What your God was doing in a little girl's vagina? What your God was doing in a little girl's vagina?
Sunan Abu Dawud.
Yes, not Bukhari. Who's the Bukhari?
Abu Dawud. That's his man.
Okay, go on.
You don't listen.
Okay, when he reads it, bear in mind, he says, okay, to kill babies.
Hadith 162.
Go on.
Okay, so narrated Salama ibn al-Aqwa. The Messenger of Allah appointed Abu Bakr our commander, and we fought with some people who were polytheists, and we attacked them at night.
Attacked them at night.
Killing them. Yes? So we attacked them at night, killing them.
Yes.
Our war cry that night was put to death, put to death. Salama said, I killed that night with my hand, polytheists to seven houses.
Wait. So why are you reading this one?
Hold on.
Why is he reading
this? Forget it, man.
Anyway, this is it. Subhan Ibn Majah, the chapters on jihad.
Now, if I'm going to make a claim, I have to back it up. Not ask the person to back it up for me. You making the claim, you need to back it up. So my question to the Christians here, is it okay to slaughter a baby's alive intentionally?
If God says so, yes.
If God says yes, so if God says to Prophet Muhammad to marry Aisha, what is the problem of you? You see? So you have no problem. So your problem is not he got married to Aisha. Your problem, Prophet Muhammad was no prophet. That's the problem. So about Aisha, about fighting, they have no problem with that. Why? Because in the Bible says, burn your daughter alive. Wait. Would you burn your daughter alive?
It is Sahih.
Wait.
It's Sahih.
No, I didn't say that.
No, is this Sahih? You said that it was not offensive.
I said, what's it to you? Ibn Majah, not every narration there is Sahih.
It's Sahih.
But there's another narration in Bukhari.
Is this narration Sahih?
No, I don't know about this one.
No, but that's what we're showing you. It's Sahih.
Listen, next time, just bring the book, man.
Read it.
Yeah, Darussalam. I don't know about Darussalam.
It's Sahih.
No,
just bring the book next time.
By who?
This is it.
What's his name? Read it.
what?
Read, who says Sahih? Wait, who's Abu Salam?
You tell me.
No, you!
Hey, listen, allow it! Shamsi!
Shamsi! I know, you much better than him. But come on, man.
Shamsi, you're wasting your time, man. Allow it, man.
Abu Salam is not, it's a bookstore.
Okay.
Okay?
Black wheels!
So, are you saying?
No, no, I didn't say that. I said the hadith I know.
Let me just.
The hadith, wait. My point here was, yeah? What they try to compare when God said in the Bible to slaughter the babies alive with the hadith in Sahih Bukhari. Sahih Bukhari, what happened? I was explaining to him, the Messenger of Allah sent an army to fight against his enemies, yes? So what happened when he attacked them by night? In the morning they found out there were children and women among them. So they went to compare the Prophet Muhammad, said, oh Prophet Muhammad, so what you have to understand, Prophet Muhammad never ordered it. He never said go and kill them. The companions, they never knew about it. So they went back. So don't ever try to compare.
No, you missed it. Okay, you give us your criteria.
This is not the Bible.
Okay, wait.
You give us your criteria.
Wait, is it good? Let me share this benefit. How do we know authentic hadith? ما رواه العدل الضابط عن مثله إلى منتهى بغير علة ولا شذوذ. A chain of narrators that all of them are trustworthy, honest, with a strong memory, and all of them met each other without going and guess what is one known. So if a narration go and guess what is no one known, then you become shudud, okay? And the illa without a hidden deficient. That's for the hadith to be authentic. So therefore, you don't know the name of the narrators, all of them.
Give us all the narrators for...
You are bringing it on me.
No, you're saying...
Oh, this is a joke.
This is your criteria.
This is a joke.
So you're
not my criteria, Godwin. That's not my criteria.
I'm responding to you.
It's the criteria of Islam. Okay?
You're wasting your time.
Why? Muslims, is it okay to slaughter babies alive?
No!
Is it okay to slaughter babies alive?
Yes.
Is it okay? He's taking him time to say no. I want people to put in their title Arab Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi and his crew in speaker's corner.
Okay, so...
Look at his face, He looks unhappy.
Muhammad said, I've been made victorious with terror. Explain that.
No, that's a good one. That's a good one. He said that...
Black dogs.
The far right would say that.
He said, good question.
Yeah.
Look, you see, if you ask, I will answer, no problem. He said, Prophet Muhammad, can you ask us of Hakim? She's Hakim. Okay. She's talking to me.
Didn't your mother tell you?
Here we go.
My mother, she never mixed with too many men.
Well, she didn't.
Okay, alhamdulillah. Anyway, my point here is, and you know I respect you. You know, in the conversation. Yeah, but you stress yourself about Prophet Muhammad. Yeah, but that's what you said. I was asking, look. I was asking him, he believed marriage is sex, and you agreed with him.
No, I said you've got more chance of having sex within a marriage.
No, but Ahmad, that's not my question. Why are you buttering if you don't know what I was saying?
I wasn't answering.
Okay, sorry for misunderstanding. No, sorry. You see, as a Muslim, I'm a respectful person, alhamdulillah. If I'm wrong, I would say sorry. Without illa. That's my teacher, my Prophet Muhammad, who said, do not kill children and women, as-salam, by the way. Okay? So now, Prophet Muhammad said, from the miracles that Allah has given him, if he's going to wage war against enemies, his enemies, that Allah will cause a fit in their heart. So what's the problem with that?
Where's that from, so I can read?
It's Sahih Bukhari, it's hadith.
Give me the name so I can...
The name is Abu Abdullah Muhammad bin Ismail Bukhari.
No, the reference. Sahih Bukhari, what book?
Huh? Hadith. Hadith Jabir, the narrator is Jabir bin Abdullah.
He's going to say
that. So Sahih Bukhari...
Jabir bin Abdullah. I don't know. I'm not a computer, Google here. My name is Shamsi, by the way.
No,
but you can check it anyway. But the point here is, now, tell me, would you burn your daughter alive? Would you burn your daughter alive?
What's that qāla?
What happened to your bit? It's in green.
What's that qāla?
It's in green.
Where's your bit?
None.
Where's your bit?
You have none.
Where's your bit?
Ask, I have more than you.
Why is your bit not growing?
Allah created me this way.
You're polyfish. That was your word and you're polyfish.
Oh, come on. That's bad arguments.
Anyway,
brothers and sisters, what you see that we the Christians, they try to justify burning your daughter alive. In the Bible, says if your daughter she's a prostitute, you should burn her alive. Excuse me, would you burn your daughter alive?
No, me no. I won't.
So you don't follow Bible? He doesn't follow God. So you don't follow God?
Will you kill a Muslim who's pious?
No, 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 no. Wait. No, wait.
Will you honor the assassination of a Muslim?
Wait. I will not kill him, no.
Wait. I already answered you.
You have asked me.
I said no.
So you got what's wrong? We said to do it.
Okay, so answer my question.
So you're not Christian. He just become kafir. He become disbeliever in the Bible. Alhamdulillah. Soon become Muslim. We have one here. Put him aside.
If you're prophet, or
would you burn it to the light?
My
question. All Christians, answer my question, please. Would you burn your daughter alive?
No.
Your prophet ordered the assassination of a Muslim because he was being too pious.
Because the Bible says that. You're not Christian. Akhwa, you know Christians, you should wear niqab. You should wear niqab, you too. Your Bible full of burning daughters alive. And if your wife, watch, imagine you're fighting and your wife hems you in fight. You know what is the reward? Cut her off her hands. Imagine instead of saying, thank you, my wife, for helping me. They're following the Bible, by the way.
Okay.
So, Shamsi.
He agrees. He agrees. Alhamdulillah. Would you burn your daughter alive? Would you burn your daughter alive? Would you burn your daughter alive?
Would this boy innocent?
Would you burn your daughter alive?
Did Allah allow for innocent child to be killed?
Okay, go.
Did he allow
that? Yes or no?
Did Allah allow for innocent child to be killed?
He was no child.
He was
no child. Ghulam means he was a young boy.
So he was a young boy?
Yes, young boy.
Okay,
do you know why? No, do you know why? No. Wait.
So what is the child?
Wait.
He said, do not take me to...
Again, my question. No, my question. My question. He has an answer. Would you burn your daughter alive? Muslims, would you burn your daughter alive?
No.
Christian, ISIS, would you burn your daughter alive? Are you ISIS follower?
Let me speak and then
you
respond. Shamsi.
Are you ISIS, by the way?
Shamsi.
Are you ISIS? No, are you ISIS?
Let me speak and you respond.
Don't you think you're going on?
He was reading from the Quran.
I'm not going to let him read and you answer my questions.
Okay,
answer my questions. Is it okay to burn your daughter alive?
So they set off after leaving the show. Look at you. What are you running to? So they set off after leaving the ship.
They love Jalalayn. Jalalayn cannot handle this.
When they met a
that's
boy.
That's not Quran.
When they do not yet reach puberty.
The verse doesn't say that. The verse doesn't say that. That's the verse.
Okay.
Yes. Wait. He doesn't know tafsir from the verse.
Please.
That's not tafsir.
It doesn't matter what the Quran. No. I'm talking about what.
I don't blank from the scholars.
So you know more than the scholar.
No, wait.
You know more than Adjali.
I'll tell you what. I don't black follow him.
No, he's not infallible.
That's it.
Let's read this. Okay.
Go ahead.
Why are you reading this not first? If the Bible says kill babies and children,
playing with other
are you going to kill babies?
Among
boys,
whom his face
when he said kill babies alive, that's a Bible reading, by the way.
And Al-Qadir slew him by slitting his throat with a knife. While he lay down, or by tearing
that's not verse,
his head
not verse,
off
his that's not verse.
Or by smashing
give me verse.
His head against a wall.
I gave you proof.
All
you read the Bible.
Opinions of the coordination. Allah allowed for this to happen. Yes or no?
Can I speak now?
Yes or no?
Can I speak?
Yes or no?
In order to say yes or no, I have to speak.
Go on.
Yes or no.
Thank
no,
you.
No, only say
so
yes.
Allah allowed for that. That's all we need to know.
Take care. Kill babies alive. When I said the young boy Allah sent the Quran, he was going to grow up as an evil boy. But in the Bible, it's the most
joyful. Quick rapper.
Yeah, quick rapper. Yeah. So yeah, no, I mean, every week Shamsi comes along and he pulls out all these random Old Testament verses about God, you know, allowing for innocent children to kill. But clearly in the Quran, when you read it, it clearly states that Allah allowed for innocent child to be killed. And when we read it, it says his head smashed. It was a brutal, ugly death that this child received. It was an innocent child, which Allah allowed to happen. And so it makes no sense for Shamsi then to go around and start saying, well, hold on, look at what the God of the Old Testament did. See, God, in our scripture, we know that God creates life and also has the right to take life away. But what Muslims would say that if it's an innocent child, God doesn't have the right. But in the Quran, it states that clearly, and it's backed by the scholars, clearly that Allah allowed for innocent child to be killed. Why? Because they thought that sometime in the future, this child would commit some type of sin, which doesn't make any logical sense. I would encourage my Muslim friends to turn away from that false God of the Quran and come to the truth, what God of the Bible. God bless you.